movies with you as long as you're wearing that bag of garlic around your neck. Oh, go on. That's just superstition. It don't keep off colds. It just keeps off friends. Charlie, I ain't got time to argue with you. Kevin's arriving any minute now. Oh, he's Mr. B's nephew. He's going to be staying with us for a while. Okay, Charlie. Sure. Call later. Bye. Poor fella. He gets lonely.
Won't anybody talk to him?
Just over the phone. It's that way every year. By the time it's spring, he's glassy-eyed and muttering to himself. It's pathetic. Is he here?
Well, I heard a car, but I guess it was next door.
I fixed up the guest room. I wanted to put some fresh flowers in there, but there ain't nothing left in the garden.
Well, I'm sure a boy just out of the army can survive without flowers in his room.
His wife might like them.
Well, son, Helen won't be with him.
She won't? Why not?
Well, you see, sport, Kevin and Helen ain't exactly married no more.
Hazel, yes, they are still married.
Well, she wrote him asking for a divorce. Any wife that'd do that when her husband is overseas ain't worth... Oh, the little snip. I'd like to turn her over my knee.
Hazel, that's enough.
What's going on?
Well, we were just telling Harold about Kevin and Helen.
She's going to divorce him.
Yes, I know. Somebody should give that girl a good spanking.
Right.
All right, you two. Now, we don't know how or why she came to such a decision, and it's unfair to judge her without knowing the facts.
Any girl that tries to divorce her husband when he's overseas ain't worth...
All right, Hazel, let's stop talking about it.
2 cents.
Hey, Hazel, where's that new box of candy? I want to put it out for Kevin.
Oh, I'll get it for you, Missy. I hid it in one of the top shelves in the kitchen. I didn't want you-know-who eating it all up.
Oh, Harold wouldn't eat all that candy.
Oh, I didn't mean Harold, Mr. B.
One of these days, that woman's going too far.
Harold, now I want to warn you about Kevin. Don't mention Helen to him at all. We don't want to make him feel badly.
Yes, I agree. None of us should say anything. If he wants to talk about it, let him bring it up. Oh, there he is.
Where's his rifle?
Son, they have to turn them in.
That's a chip.
Oh, is he here?
He just drove up out front.
Do I look all right?
Oh, you look fine.
Hi, Kevin.
Welcome home, Kevin.
Welcome, Kevin.
Oh, is it me,
Kevin? Oh, that's so good to see you.
Oh, it's good to be back. Welcome, Kevin. Thanks, Uncle George.
Hi, Kevin. Did you bring a pain in?
I'm afraid not, Adam. Hey, you've grown.
I know it. He's in your pants. Hi, Kevin.
Oh, Hazel, how's my favorite letter
run? Oh, terrific. Give me a big hug. That's better. Boy, you're handsomer than ever. That little snip must be out of her mind. Now that you're back in the old neighborhood, you're going to have the time of your life, right, Mr. B?
Right, Hazel.
You're going to meet some nice girl, and you'll just forget that little snip ever existed.
Well, should we go in the house? We have a lot of catching up to do.
I'll go here. I'll get it.
Did it?
Do you have a hand grenade?
Oh, hell, I haven't. Anything new
for
your father and mother, Kevin?
No, I'll be getting back from Florida next week.
Oh.
I sure appreciate your putting me up until then.
Oh, don't be silly. You're welcome to stay here as long as you like.
Sure, you couldn't be more welcome if you was a blood relative.
Hazel, he is a blood relative.
Oh, I mean a mine. I think you're just dying to call all your old friends.
Well, not right away. I'll see.
Well, let's go inside.
Sure, come on in. Well, Kevin, then your friends will probably be calling you. I bet you wrote them all you was coming home.
No, nobody except you and my parents and you.
Oh, well, then how do you expect to get back in circulation?
Well, I'm really not sure I want to get back in circulation. If you don't mind, I'd like to go upstairs and unpack. Same room?
Same room.
I'll be down in a little while.
He's been hurt and he's withdrawn from people, I guess.
Well, we'll get him back in the swim.
Hazel, please don't interfere.
Well, Mr. B, you know I got this terrific understanding of psychology.
Hazel, Kevin will resent any effort on your part.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. B. That's the residence. Oh, hi, Charlie. No, I don't think Murray'd go out with you either. Well, you gotta face it, Charlie. That bag of garlic around your neck is a social handicap. Well, of course you can. Just call any time. And if
I ain't here, just talk to Mr. B or anybody that answers the phone.
Sure, Charlie.
Bye.